Majority of you already know me. And without wasting time, let's start our day. The question solving, even I don't know what are the questions, I don't know what are the answers. Let's try to solve them in a random way. I just took it directly from the simulator, downloaded. So let's enjoy the fully prepared exam environment as a random question. Great. We'll focus only on the question, and I'll keep giving you the hints, and I'll keep highlighting how to select the answer. So I'll use highlighters also. You guys can see the screen, right?
Yep.
Perfect. Let's begin. Project manager with limited experience managing globally distributed team is appointed to a project with team members who are all from another country and speak a different native language. To manage the project, you need to have what? Cultural sensitivity. Which of the following actions should the project manager not take? So if you could answer it on the chat window, take your time. And then we will discuss it and what could be the correct answer. And we'll discuss it also. Okay, nine. That's correct, actually. Stuart, you need to select one, and one answer of yours is correct. Great. What about others? Ravinder, yes. Good. Walid, no. Stuart, yes. That's a correct answer, actually. Nazir, you are not looking at the question, right? They are asking not take. You will keep missing. Means I'm not saying to you, I'm saying to everyone, if you will not look what the question is asking, your answers will be incorrect. So when we have this type of situations, first we need to find out what we should do so we can find that answer which we should not do. So if you need to know about cultural sensitivity, you have to read the book. You have to hire a professional coach. You have to enroll in a language course or in a language or cultural sensitivity course about that particular country. But requesting a different assignment will not be a correct answer. So in that case, our answer was C, and those who have answered C, yes, that's actually the correct answer. So
Imran,
yeah, go on.
I was going towards C, but the reason I selected a different answer was the first line, which said a project manager with limited experience. And in my brain, I was thinking, if I had limited experience, can I not ask for a different assignment? Because
look,
I was putting myself.
You were thinking correct. But I explained you something, that question contains two parts, right? This part,
yeah, the last,
and this part. And the last part is the question. So if you will select on the first part, your answer will always be wrong. Yeah, look, sorry. I can make your, no, it's okay. I can make your answer correct if I remove it. And I can put something here as limited experience about the field. Means project manager belongs to engineering and the project belongs to IT. So in that case, C could be the correct answer. Because it's not your field, you cannot take the answers from your field. So yeah, yep. You have to, you should not, this is the PMI condition also. If you don't have the knowledge about the field you are working in, do not accept the assignment. So yeah, in that case, C could be the correct answer. So, but here they change it with the cultural sensitivity. Yeah. So as a project manager, this is your part of the project, the power skills, you have to use it. Soft skills, communication skills. Great.
I forgot the tip. Thank you for reminding
me. No problem. Yeah. This is the purpose, actually. This is the purpose of the session, just to keeping you awake. Okay. No problem. A software project needs a solution to collaborate with a remote agile team of 4 people in another country. Spontaneous verbal communications between the team must be supported. All the remote teams, workstations, and Kanban board must be visible at all the time. This is the keyword, okay? And everything should be visible at all the time. Which virtual team collaboration solution is most appropriate? First, find out the reason why we are solving this question, then select the answer. Okay, still it's not the correct answer. Still no one is reaching to the correct answer.
I forgot what a fishbowl windows is.
Okay. Look, those who are selecting, this is what must be visible all the time, correct? So when you're saying must be visible all the time, on demand will be the answer. It can never be the answer.
When oh, on saying, demand.
On demand. It says available all the time. So why we need to create a demand? V is gone. Workstation screen mirroring is not an ethical act.
Is that remote monitoring or something? Is it? What's that?
Okay. So workstation mirroring. Yeah, workstation mirroring is not a good idea, right? That you cannot sneak a peek into my monitor without, or I should not be doing into that. The question is not asking about only progress. If it is only progress, answer would be the information radiator. But they are not asking about progress, right? Information radiators are what? Burn down chart, burn up chart, and product backlog. So A is also gone. Now, what is this? Always on fishbowl window is. In the last training, I think, Ryan, it was in your class maybe, or it was in another one class?
Yeah, I remember the term. I've just Googled it, but I remember the term fishbowl.
Ali was saying that nowadays companies are using in the interviews also, that what happened, they place the people in the center and these guys are discussing and you or your team are looking from outside and listening to their conversation. That is called as fishbowl windows.
I remember you mentioning it as well.
Yeah.
Yes, in articles. Yeah, thank you. I forgot.
So again, revision is good, right?
Yeah, I've never heard of it before.
That's So that is called as fishbowl windows. And if those who have not heard it, so because the topic has arrived and we don't want to miss any opportunity to leave any doubts to the next level. Let me show you on the browser also. Here is it. If you guys look at it, this is actually the concept of fishbowl window. You can see the browser, right?
Yeah.
Yep.
And the second thing which I draw the picture on the thing is like this, that these people are sitting in the middle and the participants are looking at the screen and whatever they are doing. So you are trying to learn from their discussions, that's what they are discussing. So in organizations, we make something like this. This is fishbowl. Mm. And these are the moderators. So must be visible at all the time. So you can listen to their communication and whatever they are doing. This is called a fishbowl window. So now you have seen it, you will never forget it. Great, let me take you back to the slides. And here we are.
Just a quick question. That fishbowl, I'm assuming, because they're remote teams, I'm assuming it would have to be over video.
The virtual one.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, so it's a virtual fishbowl. Yep.
Yes.
Okay.
Look, if you look at it, workstation is screen mirroring. So you can only see their workstations. This is half of the answer. But what about the Kanban boards all the time? So then fishbowl window is the best answer.
Mm-hmm. What is the radiator monitor?
Information radiators are the burn-up charts, burn-down charts, product backlog, iteration backlog, Kanban boards. So it's about the progress.
Yeah.
Great. Let's go next. Members of a virtual agile team are separated by different time zones. Daily meetings are too long. This is the problem, okay? And the problem is made worse when laptop cameras switch between the speaking members. Which two measures should the project manager take to achieve shorter, more efficient daily meetings? You need to select two correct answers. Mr. Waleed. We need to select two answers, right? And then both of your answers are not correct. Stuart. Okay. The problem is meetings are too long and camera is switching. When the daily standard meetings are too long, it means they are discussing more than what is required. Because in daily standard meeting, we have three questions, right? What you did yesterday, what you will do today, and what are your impediments, challenges, or obstacles? So they are discussing challenges, impediments, and obstacles. So I think all have answered on the list. I hope so. Let me discuss it. So if you look, one of the answers is ask the team member to raise blockers offline. And this is the best one, right? Or no?
No, because the whole idea of a stand-up is to bring blockers. So why would you want to take it offline? Doesn't make any sense.
Okay. Great. Now, if you look at it, requires all member to stand during the full meeting. We are not in the school, right? Or we are in the school. Okay, I'll keep it. Limit speakers to only members who have made progress. We discussed that if you have this word in the question,
it's wrong.
It will never be the correct answer. So it's gone. And it's gone.
Mm-hmm.
So now from the remaining three, you need to select two. So use the iteration reviews to discuss the Kanban board. Iteration reviews are there to get the feedback, right? They are not for the progress. So those who have selected B and C are actually the correct answers.
Because the answer of standing during the meeting, I don't know, it just didn't seem right to me, but anyway.
Look, sometimes what happens that you have multiple answers and you have to choose from those answers. Sometimes you will feel it that one of them is not appropriate as it should be, but you have to choose from the available one. If it is not given, it's not given, you have to only find out from these things. So if you see that it has a word which we don't like it, right? But here it is the only available option for us. We can select because the other options we have already eliminated it. So in that context, the remaining answers are B and C.
So how is B a correct answer here? I couldn't select B because I thought they wanted a short meeting. But if we require all members to stand during the full meeting, aren't we saying it's a long meeting, or did I not understand?
Daily stand-up meeting, we know that it's 15 minutes, right?
Yeah.
So, okay, we can stand up. So the camera, when it is switching, it can go to every places. That's why B and C are matching.
Okay.
So in the options available, this is the only answer. Yeah, go on. Someone is saying something.
Yeah, I was saying, you mentioned that option A is about feedback and not progress.
Look, there are four ceremonies, right? If you remember, planning meeting, where you discuss the work.
Okay.
Daily stand-up meeting, coordination meeting, where you discuss the progress. Review meeting, where you collect the feedback. And retrospect meeting where you discuss the lesson learned and continuous improvement. Isn't it? These are the four meetings where we discuss the things accordingly. So Kanban boards can be discussed in feedback? No. We are discussing the completed work and the work which has met definition of done from Agile, what we call it, definition of done. So we only discuss, we only demo those things which have achieved definition of done. So A is wrong in that context. Does it work well?
Yes, sure, sir.
Great. Great, let's go next. A company is constructing a plant in 15 countries. The lead in the PMO wants more timely progress reporting and experience sharing between project managers in each of the geographically distant projects. So which two agile methods might the PMO use to fulfill this need? If you will keep highlighting the words in the exam with the highlighter, your answer will not be incorrect.
Unfortunately, online, that's probably a bit difficult when you take a proctored exam.
No, they have the highlighter also in the
online. Oh, wow. Oh, yeah, well, that's handy.
The simulator window, perfect. If they use it, it has the whiteboard, it has the strike off, it has the highlighter, everything, the same. So progress reporting or experience sharing has something to do with definition of done? God.
Not really.
Yep.
Kanban board is used for progress?
Yep.
Yep.
Backlog refinement has something to do with the progress?
No.
Now remainings are daily stand-up meetings and 2 weeks retrospects. So we have already done the timely progress. Kanban boards are much better than the daily stand-up, right? Because it visualizes the flow. So this is gone now. Experience sharing is retrospect. This is why I kept saying use the highlighters So you stick to the answer what they are asking.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I just looked at the progress. I just looked at the progress reporting and didn't see the experience sharing. That's why I got it wrong.
Keep using the highlighters. Your life will be easy.
I have no faith in myself anymore.
It's not about faith. I told you that time you will delay the exam after the training. You will keep forgetting the things and your momentum will go down. So the earlier you will take it after the training is better. That's why I started this thing. Although I finished one class yesterday and I was thinking that I will sleep today. This will be the first night after 10 nights that I could sleep in the night. But no, I said, let's continue it for one more night to have a session so I can enjoy the benefits. I mean, the last week was very horrible. I had my job, I had a training in the evening and then I had a training on the whole night also. But I still, I commit that, okay, I will do it.
But
I, my Thank Australia and New Zealand students are getting very disconnected. I'm not say lazy or delayed, disconnected from the things. And I want them back on track so they can also pass the exam. Okay, a planned task and a sprint was nearly not completed because of an issue that appeared 3 days prior, but was not resolved. So issue has occurred and is still not resolved. Then the team resolved it in the next daily standard meeting. But the project manager wants to prevent. The answer should meet the word prevent. So what should the project manager do? We need to do the preventive measures. So preventive measures are discussed where? You know the answer.
Retrospective?
I can take your answer, let other answers also, then I will say that your answer is correct or not. That's why I will say now, they will take your answer directly. Yep. Things are going in the right direction so far. All are correct. What about others? There are two more guys here, right? Qasim and Waleen and Robinjo, and there's Pergul also. Qasim and Waleed, your answers are here. Did I see them? Not yet. Waleed, yes, good. Nazia, I just said, right?
No.
I just know, said the purpose of daily sender meeting, right? And the purpose of retrospect meeting and the purpose of planning meeting. Yeah. Demo, we don't address the issue, right? It's the daily stand-up meeting. So B is gone. In planning a meeting, we don't discuss the continuous improvement. We do in the
retrospect.
And send an email. This second, this is like secondary option, right? Here, it's like a push type of communication. You are not supposed to get reply. You don't know the person will read the email or not. You don't know, whatever it's happening. So the best answer is retrospect. Great. And the way I'm using highlighters, I'm just trying to teach you that how to use highlighters in exam to stick to the plan, not to go in the mess. A PM went on vacation and returned to Discord. According to two stakeholders, stakeholder C is causing problem. Every day for the last 2 weeks, stakeholder C sent an email to the team checking progress and giving new instructions. Team ignored the email and continue working, but the other stakeholders are concerned about stakeholder C. Before going into the answers, wait, don't run for an answer directly. You remember the stakeholder engagement assessment metrics? And we had five categories or classifications of stakeholders. One was unaware, right? One was resistant. One was neutral. One was supportive. And one was leading. This stakeholder C is trying to be what?
Resistive.
He's trying to be the
leader, yeah.
Leading, he's trying to go beyond the limit. And this is alarming for everyone. So in that context, what you should do as a project manager. And we said that this word and this word will never be the correct answer, right? As a project manager, we do not ignore anything. And as a project manager, we do not invite everyone. We invite relevant people, right? Everyone will never be the correct answer. So A and B are gone out of the list. Remaining answers are C and D. So here we have a conflict, right? Conflicting situation. So before solving the problem, you have to understand the problem or just solve the problem directly. Great. First, find out what is happening.
Yeah.
Then collect your points. So first, correct answer is this. After D, you will go to C.
But I thought the private conversation would be a form of investigation.
Whenever you guys read about negotiations, there is a model called as R. Agreement, relationship, and maintain. Before going into negotiations, you should collect the data, what you will negotiate. They are saying you just came back from the vacation. You don't know what was happening on your back. So you don't know. Maybe they are lying. Maybe they are saying something, but you are not able to understand.
Everyone caught me out there. I thought I just assumed everyone meant the people that the stakeholders that have been affected by it. Yeah. Silly me.
You know, the bad functional manager do this. That invite everyone. Come on, guys. Come on, everyone. Let's discuss it. Let's just waste time as much as possible.
Well, I had a very similar question a few days ago from somewhere. And the question was like, one of the team members has got some problems and everyone else are ignoring that person. And the answer was to have a session with that problem person and solve it. And the explanation was root cause analysis takes a lot of time and money. So it's best to talk to that person. If you can't resolve it, then go through the root cause analysis process.
You gave the answer by yourself. There is a difference between team and a stakeholder. They both are stakeholders, but team members are immediate ones. Stakeholders could be external people.
Okay.
Did you get the point? If I have the problem with my team, I will use my emotional intelligence and skills and ask him what's going on instead of thinking. But if it is the external stakeholder, let me think what he's trying to achieve or she's trying to achieve. Then we will hit it back. So the word, if I remove the team, if I remove this word stakeholder and says team, then C could be the correct answer. So one word will change the whole answer. Because when it's related to the team, we need to resolve the issues at the same time. Okay, let's go. A frustrated agile team member approaches the PM to complain that a senior team member is claiming all the interesting backlog items and leaving the tedious activities for everyone else. How would you address this as a complaint? Yeah, once you become the project manager, you are like the mother to them. Everyone is coming to you. Mother, this has happened. What to do? That's great, Stuart. Very good. Yep, right. You have to take the actions which is in the best interest of maximum people. I will not say everyone or all, based upon the maximum audience or based upon the maximum impact. You should not take any actions which are only limited to one person. And majority of the conflicts can be resolved by a single document called as
a team charter.
Exactly. Ground rule and team charter. These type of things can easily be addressed without going into any conflict. Set the ground rules. The things will be fine.
Imran, can C ever be a correct answer in a different situation, or it can never be? Define every new rule. Someone like we PMs will not be. We cannot define our new rule, right?
Should not. Yes, we can, but we should not. It has to be done by the team.
By the team, yeah, cool.
So don't try to do the things which you are not.
Yeah, but I just wanted to understand if that can be ever be an answer in a different situation.
No.
Okay.
And I think whether you go with predictive, whether you go with agile or adaptive, it will never be the correct answer. Ground rules and team charter should be set up by themselves. Yeah. You can supervise the session, guide them, coach them. They should select it. So yes, D was the correct answer. Let's go next. The company has hired a new architectural excellence board with a mission to promote new programming paradigms. The Agile team continues to work on new and existing software products. How should the project manager deal with this new development? Inform the Agile team that resulting changes will be postponed as long as possible. Be patient and wait until the board gives the explicit instructions. Speak with the PO to add the change. Negotiate a quiet period with the board to prevent disruptions to the team's work. Stuart, yes, that's great. Nausea, yes. All right, no. Ryan, this could be in terms of as a functional manager, but in project manager, you have limited time. So D would not be the appropriate answer. If you are in functional, maybe yes. But in projects, no. You have to follow, right? What we call it in Agile, adaptable. We have to be resilient. We have to be adaptable. So you have to adapt whatever is going on. We should not wait for it. So yes, those who have selected C, their answers are correct. And I hope I explained the way you could understand. Let's move forward. A PM develops a project management plan and a schedule based on an agreed upon project life cycle of, what is project life cycle?
Duration of the project?
No. On the chat window, Kasim, here the same place. Yes. What is the definition? You can answer it on the mic. It's okay. Definition things you can answer on the mic. No problem.
So it's a suite of stages or phases that a project goes through from initiation.
The number of phases which completes the project. Right? The number of phases which completes a project is called as project life cycle. Every project will have fixed number of phases?
No.
No. So later, due to changing business requirement, a sponsor requests completion within 9 months. When you read this, do not try to go to the answers. What I told you, when you are reading the question, you should have a pop-up built in, right? And you should be able to search that pop-up down. When you're going from 16 months to 9 months, what options you have it? What we call this thing?
Schedule compression.
Schedule compression techniques. And how many techniques we have?
Crashing is one of them. Crashing. And something else.
There was another one. Two, I think, isn't it?
Yes, crashing and fast tracking. In crashing, we add more resources. In fast tracking, we do the work in parallel. So now you know that these things are. The purpose of this to recall the information. But now let's read the question. How should the project manager respond to the change? Anyone remembers the flowchart of the change? Whenever the change is filed, what we have to do as a project manager? Whenever the change request is filed, it will go where? Literally, you guys have to read it. It will go to the change log. And after change log, it will go to project manager. Project manager will evaluate the change and evaluate the change on project objectives. What are the project objectives?
Scope, time,
cost, and quality. And he's not the decision maker or she's not the decision maker. They will write down the recommendations and put in the process called as perform integrated change control, where change control board will review the change. They could accept, reject, or defer the change. Whatever the outcome is, project manager has to communicate that project, the change request was filed and it's approved, reject, or deferred. And if it is approved, then update the document. That was the flow, right? Are we able to recall the information? Now, based upon that information, so if you go with this information, which answer is correct now? Yes, Kasim, your answer is correct. Thank you.
Can you check my answer? The last one.
Is it?
I'll do it again.
Yeah, your answer is also correct. And direct action will never be the correct answer, right? That's what I taught you. Direct action will never be the correct answer. And you cannot do this, right? It's not team member, it's a sponsor who will decide what we can remove it. So D is gone. Work with key stakeholders and team members to discuss the business requirement. We are discussing about the schedule, not business requirement, right? So B is gone. So remaining answer is A anyway, which means you have to perform the impact analysis of the change request. And this is what the flow, right? Change request, change log, and this is step number three, which is evaluate the change. Yes, Mr. Wadi, very good. Ryan, yes. Every answer will give you that I am correct or incorrect. Just keep highlighting the words in the question, and especially in the last part, focus on it. So you can actually match. It's like once you do the highlighting, you are like matching the words in the context. Great, let's go next. A PM needs to ensure that the team delivers business value within the required timeline. The PM recently learned that key stakeholders are worried that the current release plan will not meet urgent business needs. When you read this, forget the question. When you read this, what should come in your mind? What we are going to discuss? What options you might have it? Anyone can recall during the training what we learned? When you have this type of situation, business value, business needs, what the question is trying to ask. We discuss that you should make MVP first and then release the MBI. Yes, Robinja, great. Right, and we can use prioritization techniques also, Moscow, Kanu, or 100-point methods. So how can the project manager effectively respond to stakeholder concerns? If you are not understanding the questions and you are going in rush to find the answer, you know what will be the result? That if you will jump to the answers directly after reading the questions, you will reread them again and again, and you will waste your time. So while reading the question, you should have some answers built in your mind that you can understand, and then you can go and search about them. Don't just jump directly into the answers until you know what is it. So based upon the situation, what is the correct answer? That's great, Kasim. Good. And yes, Robinder, yes, good. SPI has nothing to do with the question, right? Burn down chart has nothing to do with the prioritizations. And release plan has nothing to do with the WBS.
Would A be correct if it was a predictive project?
Project manager renegotiate the scope or product owner renegotiate the scope?
You know, if it was a waterfall project, though, that would be the correct answer.
Waterfall project, then yes.
Yep.
That we need to find out what you need, boss. Explain it. Then we can discuss it instead of going into the further things. So yes, those who have answered correct, exactly. B is the correct answer. If you have done this practice, what I just explained and I kept showing you, that you must have an answer before going into the answers so you can match it. Otherwise, you will keep reading the questions and answers again and again to waste time, nothing else. Great. A customer indicates.
Imran.
Yeah, go on.
What was the MVP goes to?
MVP, you will make it and you will show it as a prototype to the stakeholders. If this is, yes, that's what we need, then you will release it as a business increment. To make sure that you are only releasing what they need, not everything.
Yeah.
Okay. A customer indicates that they would like to add a functionality to a product in development. Although this request is made during execution stage, PM determines that the cost would be small. The additional functionality, if successful, would increase the opportunity for profit. What should the project manager do? Whenever there is a change, what should the project manager do? Impact analysis, right?
Yep. So
based upon the current options, which option you feel is a better option? If you look at A, you are denying the change. And we said in projects, change is the only constant. So A is out because of this. whenever the change is filed, we learn it should be submitted and evaluated.
Just a question, shouldn't you do the evaluation before you submit the change request, or you do the change request and then evaluate? I just, logically, I thought it would have been the other way around.
What you are saying, you are thinking like this. You are thinking on this part.
Ah, okay, yep.
This is request initiator.
Okay, yep. Nah, that makes sense.
Yes. So move forward. Why to move forward? And this is for the unidentified risk, right? Not unidentified requirements. So C is gone. And if you look, identify an already developed feature. When there is a new feature, question is saying itself, there's a new feature. So why will we go with the already available things? I should take it as an opportunity. So in that context, B is the correct answer. What PMI is trying to check you that you should know the process called as perform integrated change control. Every change has to go through with a change control process. Whether you are in rush, whether you are in profit, whether you are in loss, it doesn't matter. It must go via integrated change control. And you must remember as a project manager, whatever happens, you will not go here and there. They have defined a standard, you have to follow it. Why the change request have to go through with this process? What are the reasons?
To stop scope creep and goal plating.
Exactly, to avoid goal plating or scope creep. Every change should be authorized. During one daily stand-up meeting, team members suggest that the rework is being caused because there seems to be too much work. The rework is being caused because there seems to be too much work. How should the project manager respond to this? Robinjo, yes, very good. Ryan, yes, Stuart, yes. Pass and no. They are already working in time boxes and Kanban board is used for reviews. Kanban board is used for reviews or for progress. Right? So it cannot be the answer. Direct action will never be the correct answer. And they are already working in time boxing, right? Because it says daily stand-up meeting, which means that yes, they are already in the time box. So B is gone. So remaining answer is yes, D. Investigate that what is the issue, try to find out. And it's your task as a project manager to find out what is the issue, impediments, obstacles, or blockers. So you have to investigate and then take the random actions instead of taking the direct actions. Great. Let's go next. A PM for a construction firm meets with the stakeholder. All agree on a life cycle. After the work has begun, PM learns the stakeholder would like to finish in 16 months. Which step the project manager should not take? The answer they are asking, which you will not take. Waleed, yes, your answer is correct. Stuart, no. Nazia, no. Qasim, no. This is a very difficult answer you guys are choosing. In any criteria, whether it's predictive, whether it's agile, it will never be the correct answer. Whose project is this? Yours or stakeholders? It's a stakeholder needs and expectations. Why you should advise against them? Means I asked you to do something.
I kind of read advise as like trying to negotiate. That's, you know, but it is, that's a kind of a direct. Yeah, it's direct.
And if you look, so the direct action will be the answer here, right? Add team members to work more quickly. Reduce the scope and crash the schedule. Can you do this? It's not project manager task, right?
Mm. Okay.
It's not project manager task to reduce the scope and crash the schedule. It has to be done by integrated change control. Change request should be submitted, evaluated, approved by the change control board, then it should be done. So you will do everything in that context. But which step you will not take it as reduce the scope and crash the schedule? No, not possible. You are just executed. Next, a travel company wants to create smartphones for their users. Competitors are racing to do the same. Pio's vision describes several versions of the app: basic, basic ad-free, pro, and premium. Which approach is best suited to the company? And when you were reading it, I think you should have the answer in your mind, right? When I read the question, the last part, I already have the answer. Robin, do you have answered for this? Waleed, yes. Ryan, yes. Good. And based upon our learning, what we discuss, too similar will never be the correct answer.
Yep.
Right? So they will be out of the leak based upon our tricks. And remainings are incremental and iterative. So in incremental, end product is available at the end. But in incremental, we keep going and enhancing the functionality. So if you, when you are reading it, you should already have this thing in your mind that first I will release the basic version, then I will release the next version, then I will release the next version instead of waiting altogether. If I change the word, the product owner vision describes several versions to be released at once. Then it would be iterative, right? To complete the product and release, then it will be iterative. But here they are saying released, so it will be incremental is the best approach. Great. Next, an efficient agile team in a large corporation generated ideas and added innovative features to the backlog.
Imran, I have to go. Oh. Thank you very much. Always a pleasure, Dr. Imran. Thank you very much.
Thanks a lot. Really appreciate that. No worries. After the additional features are tested and complete, the portfolio owner rejects all of them, which is the most likely reason in this situation. The team did not make use of the normal quality control process. Portfolio owner refuses to pay for the team's unplanned work. Team would be entitled to intellectual property right on the feature. The product owner did not sufficiently align the ideas with the portfolio product owner. Which you think is the correct answer? And I think some of you have already answered on it. Waleed, yes, very good. Ryan, yes, good. And Nazia, if you have answered for this person, then yes, it is also correct. What about others? Everyone should try to answer before I start explaining. Okay, Rabindra, no. Question has nothing to do with quality control process. Portfolio guys deal with the quality control. What they deal with? You remember the keyword they deal with?
Strategic? No.
Exactly.
Yeah.
They deal with the strategic objectives of the organizations. So in that context, answer will be D. That strategic objectives were not aligned as they should be. That's why he refused. Because if it will not work, portfolio will not release your money, because portfolio manager is your sponsor. So you have to work in collaboration with a sponsor to get the required funds on time. It's not unplanned. There is nothing called as unplanned. The team would be entitled. It has nothing to do with the question. So yes, D was the correct answer. Great. Let's go next. The marketing director wants to be first to market to launch a version of mobile application for some audience and has asked Agile team to develop it. What should PM do to begin the development process? Work with the product owner and SMEs to break the requirement down into stories. Meet with product owner team and SME to identify risk and responses. Ask the team to estimate efforts and build business case accordingly. Meet with the product owner and SME to define the MVP. What do you think is the correct answer? And every answer I have read, they have their own explanations, which you can easily find out. Pargo, yes, very good. Who worked with the product owner to break the requirements into user stories? Project manager or team?
The team. Team does that.
Right. So here it is against the Agile. Identify the risk and responses. Who do that? Team and product owner, right? Not the project manager. Business case is the task of team or the product owner?
Product owner.
So meet with the product owner to define the MVP so we can stick to the plan and reduce the risk of errors and confusions or mismatch requirements. So yes, those who have answered D is actually the correct answer. Great, very good. Let's go next. A company is losing market share to competitors with new business model. Agile team is asked to restrict the number of features of a product and release a version more quickly to the market. How will this request impact the planning? Who was asking Valid? Valid, if you look at it, what I was trying to say, that it's a change in the product, not in the vision. So product vision has nothing to do with their releases.
No, sorry, I thought it's version. I thought I misread.
No need to apologize. We are learning how to solve the question. This session is to learn how to solve the question. Don't worry. So B is out of the league. What's the difference between backlog and sprint backlog? What's the difference? What we have in backlog and what we have in a sprint backlog?
Sprint backlog is tasks and not user stories. Yeah.
And backlog is user stories, right? So when it is task, it cannot be the answer, right? We are not discussing the task. So remaining answers are A and D. And among A and D, A is more complete answer than D. But you have to go with backlog to check which options are better. So yeah,
I was confused because with A, isn't that all agile projects to deliver increments, like deliver functionality increments?
Yes.
Isn't like this, that's just standardly how agile projects work, regardless of whether the company's losing market share and has to restrict. Like I don't get that
the
one.
Reprioritization of the backlog will occur, right? That the features which will provide highest value, they will come on the top. Or they have the urgent market needs, they will come on the top. So that's how you can.
So it's just basically a reprioritization. No other chat. Like it's just all it is. Okay.
Exactly. Yes. They are saying you want to release it quickly. They don't want to reduce it. Great. Next, the pandemic has caused delays, which will make it very difficult to launch the new product on time. TV ads for the launch date are already purchased. So the CEO has asked the PM to find a way to launch the project, even if some minor features are not included. And you know the answer. When you read this, you should have the answer in your mind. Which measures would be the most effective steps towards a successful and timely product launch? Ryan, yes, that's a correct answer. As you know, you are going against the law of inspection. They are saying if some features are not included, they are not saying if some features have error. Walid, yes. Robin, yes. Qasim, no. Double the size of the team to ensure that any defects will be detected and correctly as early as possible. Has nothing to do with the question. By doubling the team size, we double the team size for performance, not to identify the defects. And if you look, ask the team to remove product test. Means you are compromising on quality. I don't want to read even further what is written. Here it is. I cannot do that. Now remains RC and the fast track the schedule and establish the new test and readiness milestones as close as possible to the planned launch date. And if you look at D, plan a parallel iterative track to develop requirements for MVP and de-scope unnecessary predictive tasks. When you want to verify that what you are releasing is correct, the only answer you will always have it is MVP. MVP is the only way that what you are going to produce is actually the correct thing. To produce on time, to produce exactly what is required. So you are going in the right direction. And that was the video which we have seen in the MVP versus MBI. So D is actually the correct answer based upon this situation. Let's solve the last question for today. A complex project with high security protocol has key stakeholders located in different parts of the world. a senior manager requests confidential project information to be shared with a project partner. Which step you should take next? Report this breach of ethics, supply the requested information, supply the project information, or check the communication management plan. Ryan, yes, that's the correct answer, right? Who needs what information, how and when? This is the only document which will help you to remember and identify exactly. Who needs what information, how, when, in which format? So whenever you want to communicate, we have to stick to the plan that what we are going to send is actually accurate. Great. So I hope that this session has burned or extend the file to bring you back on track. And if you wish, we can do more sessions regularly, yes, based upon this information.
Yeah, that'd be great.
That would be awesome.